So just now we have told that plants also do undergo respiration process. Okay. So one of the product of the plant that is the seeds. So whether the seeds are undergoing respiration process or not, so that we can know here by simple activity. So activity number 3, release of carbon dioxide in respiration by the germinating seeds. Okay, so this is the topic what we have got. Now every activity, you know that we need to follow some basic steps. So what for we are performing this particular activity, that is aim of the activity, second step apparatus, then procedure, then observation, then conclusion, and finally precautions if at all anything are there. Right, now coming to this particular activity here. So what is the intention of performing this particular activity? So aim, so here our aim is to prove that carbon dioxide is released by the germinating seeds during respiration. So that is our aim. Once again, so carbon dioxide, to prove that carbon dioxide is released in during respiration by the germinating seeds. Okay, right. Apparatus. So every activity, we know whenever we take some material, we have to list out what are the things we require for the experiment. So here we have got, so some of the material given here. So already figure is drawn. So let us list out the things. So what are the apparatus, materials required? We require one rubber cord, we require one wide mouth bottle, then we require a small beaker, 100 or 50 ml beaker we require, then we require some amount of lime water which is prepared. Okay, lime water. Then apart from this, we require some germinating seeds or sprouted seeds. Okay, we don't directly get the germinating seeds, we have to prepare for it. So then what is the method of preparation of the sprouted seeds or germinating seeds? So in, even in our house also we can do that. Okay, take a few seeds, handful seeds of that is Bengal gram seeds. Okay, soak it for one complete night in a bowl of water. Okay, next day morning remove the water, take the seeds, put it into a cloth, cotton cloth like a kerchief cloth. Okay, and then tightly pack it. Okay, with the help of a thread or a rubber band, just tightly pack it. Then leave it as it is in the room temperature. After one day, you get the required material, that is sprouted seeds, or we can call them as germinating seeds, both mean the same. Okay, so these particular, now we have got germinated seeds are ready here. So certain type of seeds we are using here, which are known as sprouted seeds or germinating seeds. Okay, right, now moving to the procedure. Okay, so what is the procedure? So here we have to describe how we perform the experiment, right? So take one beaker with the lime water, place the beaker into the wide mouthed bottle to one side, then take a handful of germinating seeds which are already ready, put it into the bottle in this way, and now just close the mouth of the wide mouthed bottle by using a rubber cord. Okay, there is no hole to this rubber cord, it's a tightly fixed rubber cord. So fix the rubber cord as it is and just leave it for 1 or 2 days. Okay, so that is what we write under the procedure. Next, coming to observation. So after one day, so you can see there is a gradual change in the lime water, the color in the lime water. So this particular lime water, so color changes into milky white. So even in our earlier classes also we have studied, so during the combustion process, whenever carbon dioxide is released, when we burn the sugar molecules, so the released out carbon dioxide reacts with the lime water, converting into or changing it into milky white color. So here also the same. So whenever the sprouted seeds or germinating seeds are undergoing respiration, so they release the carbon dioxide, and that particular carbon dioxide is accumulated in this particular wide mouth bottle. Okay, and this release of the carbon dioxide can be observed by seeing the change in the color. So carbon dioxide gets accumulated inside this wide mouth bottle. There is no chance for the carbon dioxide to go outside, no scope at all. Okay, so it is present only in the accumulated in the wide mouth bottle. So it continuously keeps reacting with the lime water in the beaker, changing the color into milky white. So the lime water color changes into milky white. So this is observed after 1.5-2 days like that. It's a slow process. Okay, so during the process of respiration performed by the germinating seeds, carbon dioxide gas is released and that reacts with the lime water, changing the color of the water, lime water into milky white. Okay, so this is what we write under the observation. Now finally coming to conclusion, the last step. So from the above experiment, we can conclude that, okay, carbon dioxide is produced by the germinating seeds, okay, during respiration and turns the lime water into milky white. So this is what we can conclude, a simple, easy, important activity. Okay, so just now we have seen about the activity 3. Now let us move to the next one, activity 4. during respiration by generating seeds. That means during respiration process, not only carbon dioxide is produced, but also heat is produced. Okay, let us see about this. Now, again, same we have heard. So, there are some rules to follow to write an activity. So, aim of the experiment. So, aim of the experiment here is to prove that release of heat. So, heat is produced during respiration by the germinating seeds. So, that is the aim. Once again, the aim of the experiment is to prove that heat is produced during respiration by the germinating seeds or sprouted seeds. Okay, right. Now, moving to apparatus. So, whatever the materials we are using to perform the experiment, so that we write it under the heading called apparatus. So, let us see about one by one. So, first, because heat is to be recorded here, so we know the instrument to record the temperatures, so that is the thermometer. So, one thermometer we require like this, then we require some amount of cotton or thermocol to fix it at the mouth of the thermos flask. So, this is the thermos flask we have taken. So, the reason for taking the thermos flask in this experiment is there should be no exchange of the heat from outside to inside or inside to outside. So the temperature should be maintained there as it is outside. It should be the same. There is no change of exchange of temperature should be there. For that purpose, we are using the thermos flask. So in our day-to-day routine life, we know what is the use of the thermos flask. It keeps the contents inside at the same temperature at which we pour it. Okay, so say in the easier. So loss of heat can be prevented by using the thermos flask. So the thermos flask here. Next, moving to the germinating seeds or the sprouted seeds. So how to prepare the germinating seeds? In the earlier experiment we have seen. So take a few decalcium seeds, soak it into water in a bowl for a complete night. Then next morning, remove the water, put it into a piece of cloth, tie it tightly. Then one more day you wait it, you get the germinating seeds. So like this, more number of germinating seeds you are taking. Okay, now this is all what we have got the apparatus here required. Okay, now move into procedure. So what is the procedure? What is the method? So how to describe this particular experiment? So fill the thermos flask by germinating seeds or sprouted seeds. Place a thermometer into the in between this particular germinating seeds. Care to be taken that the bulb of the thermometer should be inserted in between the germinating seeds. Then close the thermos flask mouth by using some cotton or by using some thermocol. Okay, and there should be a provision provided for the inserting of the thermometer into the germinating seeds. Okay, so like this we have to make the arrangement, right? Then after this, so go for the next scientific, that is the observation. Okay, right. So what is that observation? Now after making all this arrangement, so do not disturb the apparatus. Okay, and wait for nearly about 24 hours. Okay, wait for nearly about 24 hours. And the time when you are starting the experiment, please do note down the temperature in the thermometer. Okay, timing, thermometer reading is important. Okay, now prepare a table of this type. So we need to prepare a table of this type like this. So taking the readings, so here reading number 1, 2, 3 of this type like this. Then at what time we have started? So giving a gap of every 2 hours, so take out the reading of the thermometer, timing and the temperature recorded. Okay, for example, like we have started the experiment at 10 o'clock. Okay, so first reading to be taken at 10 o'clock. So what is the temperature here? Take a recorded example like 20 degrees temperature we are observing in the thermometer. Okay, this can be easily seen, it will be a transparent one, easily it can be seen like that. So then give a gap of regular 2 hours. So for example, like again, take a second reading at 12 o'clock. You find there is a gradual increase in the temperature. For example, like something like that, 22 degrees centigrade. Again, giving a gap of 2 hours. Okay, after 12, 1, 2 o'clock. Okay, so like this. So give a gap of regular timing there, regular gap, 2 hours gap we are giving, and just try to observe the temperatures. You find there is a gradual increase in the temperature readings. Okay, you find a gradual increase in the temperature readings. Like this, near about 4 or 5, near about 6 readings you take it within 24 hours. So then what is that we can see? There is a gradual increase in the temperature. Then based on this particular temperature is coming, so whenever the respiration is performed by the germinating seeds, okay, so release of the heat takes place, and that heat release is recorded with the help of the thermometer here. So that can be clearly indicated. So by using this particular table, we can say that there is a release of heat by the generating CC during respiration. Okay, that is observation. And finally, let the conclusion. So, what is the conclusion? From the above experiment, we can conclude that heat is produced, okay, during respiration by the germinating seeds. Okay, this is what. And finally, write the precautions. So, what are the precautions we can take up in this experiment? So, one or two precautions we can write it here. So, one precaution we can write it easily. Care to be taken that the bulb of the thermometer should be inserted between the germinating seeds. This is one precaution. And one more precaution we can write it. See that the bulb of the thermometer does not touch the bottom of the thermos flask. Okay. So like these two precautions we can write for this experiment. And we can make out a difference. So here we are using the germinating seeds. Instead of germinating seeds, if you take one more setup of the same type, but instead of germinating seeds, you take the normal seeds. Okay, so then you can see that there will be no rise in the temperature. So this is particularly done by the germinating seeds or sprouting seeds itself. So this is what we call the activity number 4, release of heat in respiration by the germinating seeds.